We're here with Gene Carter-Hill, the co-founder and executive director of Imagine Englewood If. Do you do a lot of health-related stuff? Is that a big part of Imagine Englewood If?
We're doing more now.
Yeah.
We even journey with obesity, because it's all about nutrition. We've been doing a little nutrition for a couple of years now with young people, trying to make them aware of the different type of foods. Mm-hmm. And we just began to break into that. We wasn't really doing the nutrition around just 2 years.
And is this your Health Awareness Day coming up?
We're in partnership. Every year we do, on the third Saturday in May, we have a health fair. Since we discovered the lead, we have a health fair. And before that, we was kind of including our health piece with the Make a Difference Day. Mm-hmm. Let vendors come in and set up and talk about what they do. But this year, we're in collaboration with the two names at the bottom of the page, you see. That Home Health Care, and it's another organization that we're collaborating with. One thing Imagine Englewood If have decided to do, because we're about communication, collaboration, and connection. And the reason is that I took a real good look before we even started with this organization at what was happening in this community around where I am. I've worked in 4 different schools and they all was in Englewood. And I've noticed, and some of them Englewood and some West Englewood, I noticed that it's a lot of good things going on in Englewood. But who knows? Somebody cross the street doing something and I'm on the other side and don't know what they're doing. So that's why we have communication, collaboration, connection, is bringing people together. So that's what we push for. So by example, we ask other people to do the same. By example, everything we do, we try to get a partner. We bring in collaboration. So that's why we're collaborating with them with this. And then Make a Difference Day, we'd be collaborating with somebody else, or 3 or 4 people. And the decision IEI has made is that if we're going to do it, it's going to be big. And we encourage others, don't do your single thing, do it with somebody. Bring somebody on board. That's how we can build this community, and people can be empowered, and then you can hear the voice.
Mm-hmm. Englewood faces some pretty big challenges. You were at 4 different schools. Mm-hmm. What are some of the challenges for people who don't know the neighborhood? I mean, you don't get a lot of positive press. When people hear about Englewood, a lot of times they hear about crime or they hear about problems, right?
Right.
High crime rate at the moment.
Right.
What are some of the other challenges facing the community?
Well, one of the biggest challenge I think is that the media, they always say the crime is in Englewood. Sometimes it's on 79th Street, and they still say Englewood. And I don't quite understand that, because Englewood is from 55th to 75th, and it's really from the Dan Ryan over to Hamilton. You know, some people say it's Western or whatever. But for something to happen all the way in Chatham, and you say it's Englewood when it's a crime. But when it's positive, we don't hear that. And when we're doing great things in Englewood and we invite the media, they don't come.
What are some of the positive things? I mean, you've pointed out a couple of things here, the health stuff, for instance. You were telling me about some new homes being developed here.
New homes. They came out last week for the homes I gave you the address for, because Mayor Data was going to be there.
Those homes are on Ada?
Mm-hmm.
And
6200 block on Ada. They were there. They were there, the mayor was there, and all, you know, for something like that. But that's not what we're about. We're talking about positive things happening with people, even with our youth. I can't tell you when I've seen the media out here for young people doing positive things. It's always somebody got shot, mm-hmm. or somebody got a gun. Or, you know, that's the type of thing that I think damages us a lot. I've gone on field trips, and young people don't want anyone to know they're from Englewood. And I always say, do not tell them you're not from Englewood. You are. One day we're going to be on top. We might be down now. But don't ever think that you're doing so bad you can't come up.
Are there some signs in the neighborhood of improvement that you've seen? I mean, you're maybe a community group here, what are some of the signs of positive, what are some of the positive things you've seen?
Well, the house, the new housing is one. Kendra King is really one of the great things that's happening positive in Englewood, because we feel we're going to have a voice and we'll be able to participate.
Mm-hmm. That's Kennedy King, that's a community college?
Yes.
Yeah.
Community college that's located in Englewood now, but they're going to build a new college in Englewood. And we get a new police station, and I'm excited about it because it's just two blocks from my house. And in the past, we've had a hard time having community meetings before we had an office. Either had to have it at a church or a school. And if you wanted to have it in certain parks, you got to pay. And I noticed other neighborhoods had nice police stations. They could have community meetings, activities in the police station. So I'm looking forward to the police station playing that part in our community.
Do you think it will improve safety at all, having a new police station?
I don't think the police station would include safety. I think that's going to come from whoever's going to be our commander and whoever's in charge of CAPS. And I think for Englewood to be more safe, it's got to be more involvement from the community. We have some children having some concerns between Hopper and Lynn Bloom and Urban Prep. And imagine Englewood if it's working with those young people and want them to be empowered to solve their own problem, because we believe they can. If they come together, and we've had one meeting, and it was amazing to see how they work together on the inside. And these are not particularly the ones that's causing the problem, but maybe we can, I think it's going to come from the community for that. We need the support from the police station, but not for them to solve the problem. I think that's the community.